I know what's gonna happen. I'll try to go to bed with fear of failure flapping like a fruit bat in my head. I'll sleep for half an hour. The clock will ring at 6. I'll wake up in the shower with a stomach full of bricks. So I won't have any breakfast, maybe just a little tea. Like when you have to go and get a colonoscopy, which incidentally isn't half as disconcerting or upsetting as going for a purse you know there's no way that you're getting. But anyway, I'm heading downtown for the audition, where everything I'm dreading will be coming to fruition. And here's what's gonna happen. I'll walk in weak with hunger, and there's a dozen girls who look like me but 10 years younger. I'll go into the bathroom and I'll try to vocalize, and I'll be singing ming a ming a ming a ming a ming. But I'll be hearing Sandy suck, she really sucks, she really, really, really blows. And she's old and she's lame, and then someone calls my name, and here's what happens. I'll walk into the room, the gross fluorescent lighting is inviting as a tomb. And everybody smiles, they'll say it's good to see ya, but all I'll see is judges and they'll all look like Skellia. And then a little banter as they look me up and down, and somewhere through the fog of insecurity and hate, I'll try to convince them that I'm charming and I'm clever and I'm fun to have around. But I'm starting to unravel in my head, I hear the gavel. Guilty, they're gonna throw their book at me cause I'm guilty of coming in and wasting all their time. Guilty of almost every other showbiz crime. Not dumb enough, not thin enough, not pretty enough, not good enough. We hereby sentence you to a lifetime of waiting tables and debilitating self-loathing.
Sandy?
But wait, now someone's asking, so can we hear your voice? I make a lame attempt at humor, do I have a choice? I nod at the pianist, he's always wearing black. He's always in a turtleneck with dandruff on his back. No sooner do I get my note and open up my trap than inevitably some mealy-mouthed assistant director's thumbs all over his iPhone, and I know he's probably tweeting, LOL, this girl is crap. She's a fake, she's a phony, she could never win a Tony. And now I'm in a place I know quite well. I've left the world and I've entered hell. I'm this far away from a fainting spell, but just before I die, I finish a song which I oversell. Somebody says thanks and wishes me well. The next thing I know, I'm at Taco Bell, stuffing my face with meat. I'm trying to take it slowly. I'm trying to be my best. I'm trying to be more holy, less bitter and depressed. I'm reading Eckhart Tolle. He makes a lot of sense. I bought a Buddhist bowl. He says it helps you be less tense. It doesn't do a thing for me. I sit there on the floor and watch a vivid sequence of humiliating incidents from my past go by and think what kind of masochist keeps coming back for more when she knows what's gonna happen, cause it never doesn't happen, cause it always,
Sandy.
Always.
Sandy.
Michael? No. I know what's gonna happen. Don't tell me that I don't.